everyone! Welcome to yet another Maeve Mooney stream. Today what we're going to do is we're watercoloring three whole set designs. So we're going to do this one first, and then we have this one and this one to do. So let's get started. Oh, and I should probably pull up different set like references. For this one, because this one isn't the fantasy world. This one is the creek. If I can find the creeks up here somewhere. Oh, oops. That's gotta be trippy. And then this one. And then this one. I need my handy dandy. Oops. Drop the thing. One day I'll have everything set up before stream. The day is not that day, but one day. Oh, why is it a treasure? Fine, it'll be fine. Okay, color up. Color up says this color is good. Thank you. These are looking good, but let's get some bark in there. One of the things I like about watercolor is that everything you make with it is just a little bit magical. There's a very specific vibe that watercolor gives you.
Mm-hmm.
in the way that, like, no matter how good or bad you are at it, everything you make with it will just feel wild and free. Just a little bit. Because I sort of kind of have to finish all of this quickly, I'm like being a bit looser than I usually would be today. Which I think is actually nice because it creates this sort of almost dreamlike quality. Which will be very good for our next two. And it's nice for this one because, you know, TeeBee's making a friend. There's something, like a bit of that quality of it when you, like I have some childhood memories of when I was a kid, and like, there's a bit of that dreamlike quality to the memories of making friends as a kid. Because when you're a grown-up, there's like a little bit of logic to what friends you make. Like, oh, you're my friend because we're in the same field, or because you're my neighbor and I like your dog, or because, you know, there's usually a reason. But when you're a kid, you don't really need a reason. The reason is, hey, we're in the same place at the same time, and we can play together. Of course, the lasting friendships that you make as a kid, usually, like, you'll find a reason later why you really like this person. Or several reasons. Usually it being, like, you know me. you took the time to understand me in a way that most people don't. That tree bark. And I'm making the trees in the background a little bit darker bark-wise to differentiate. So that the tree that TeeBee's in stands out. All right, let's get our thing out. Okay. Tan rocks. And I'm adding some tan to the edges of this river because it's like, you know. sort of like beach almost. And I'll add some green later. Let's put some tan underneath. There's some reflection. Let's add some of this. Working very rapid fire to try and get all this done quickly. This is a faster pace than I usually would work. Thank you. Oh, this is turning out pretty good. Leaves need to be more yellow. I actually did a bit of gaming yesterday while my meds were worn off, sort of like as preparation for today and like coloring and stuff. My girlfriend has this standing theory that playing video games makes you better at making art. Especially like set design style art, because you are like exploring a design stylized 3D environment. I think that there's some merit to that, but that you should also like explore the real world too. The best styles have basis in real world stuff. Part of why I've got like these real photographs of the place that I'm painting in front of me. But I think there's merit to both approaches. And that, like, best to combine, you know? I, like, explored Legend of Zelda and Ring Fit with an eye towards design yesterday. Like, I treated it like I was a photographer almost, you know? Like, I went into the depths and I took some screenshots and, like, camera pictures with the little camera ability and stuff. And the overworld, though not as much. Because we're coming up on, you know, end of the month, which is when this needs to be done, so I figured, you know, while I was off my meds, might as well be productive in a different way. Part of that might have been the booster. Then I explored the depths specifically in preparation for, like, doing the fantasy worlds that we're gonna color next. Okay, color check. Ooh. All right, we've got some good colors going. River needs blue, ground needs, like, tan green. Start with the river blue. Now let's check. Yeah, that's a good blue to start with. And usually I would work with the my mask and fluid, but I don't really have time for that this time. So what I'm gonna try and do instead is add the like white stuff later with just like acrylic white paint. If I need it. I might not. Color check. Oh, yeah. Thank you. Oh. Alright, that's almost done, actually, I think. Oh, let's check in other color settings. Okay, it looks best in the warm light, so let's put it in cool light and make it warmer. Might be time to switch to a thinner brush. There we go. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. I think that's done. I'm gonna take a picture of it and send it over. And now, while I wait for feedback on that, let's move on to the next one. Okay. Which one should we do? You know, let's do this one first. While I've got the energy for it. Oh, I have some notes. Pay more attention to that. I don't usually get people here. That was a wonderful surprise. Okay. And now to look at so let's see. Where's my All right. Got our collage here. That's the colors that my coworker worked off of with the thumbs that I made. So let's get to it. Okay, lots of purples and reds. I'm probably gonna add some blues in there too, just to make it look good for colorblind people. Yeah, let's get started. I'm It's like a nice purple red brown here. And let's actually do a test. Thank you, Black Pencil number 2, for showing up. That was a wonderful surprise. Oh, that's a good color. Okay, let's see what it looks like in a wrap. Oh, that's pretty good. Oh, whoops. Well, I guess let's start making the color. Oh yeah, nice alien looking tree. Some blue to that. And the vibes we're going for here is like a dark fantasy forest. Want something like alien and strange, but beautiful. Okay, so this isn't gonna look as good for the people with right. Probably fine. Cool for the people with my boss's kind of color blindness, though. And I'm gonna try to find a color that contrasts against that color, that bark color for the leaves, to make it still look cool. Because these trees are looking kind of like grayish blue for people in the red-green color blindness spectrum. but like really like reddish violet brown for the people in the tritonope colorblindness spectrum. Contrasts well against that blue. Oh, there's a thought. Blue leaves. Yeah, I could do that. Sort of a reversal of the yellows that we've been leaning towards for everything else. Okay, let's add a bit more purple. This is looking cool! This'll look, whoa. A lot scarier for people on the red-green colorblindness spectrum than it will for people on the tritonope colorblindness spectrum. This is cool, okay? Like, the fact that different people experience the world in different ways. And we have the technology to account for that now when we're designing for things. It's just so cool. So, like, keep in mind the ways that different people experience the world. And like lean into it. and design around and even for it. Yeah, this is just going to look very dark for people with red-green color blindness and kind of blue. My boss wanted me to lean towards, like, red-violet for this world. Oh, actually, I wonder what my avatar looks like. Oh, that's a neat thing. I subconsciously designed around that in my avatar creation. Okay, this is looking just, like, straight up cool. Right? I mean, not cool, like, it's very warm color theory-wise, but, like... Like, in these designs, I'm sort of, like, focusing a lot more on contrast while using a lot of the colors that I haven't so far because it doesn't show up as well on different kinds of color blindness. But, like, design-wise, that's a little bit the point. Because it is a strange world that's hard to understand. It's so completely different from the world that we're used to that, like, you can't even... Like, the ways that we're evolved to understand color don't necessarily apply here. And it's fascinating, and it's beautiful, and it's so weird. And I'm leaning towards that kind of on purpose, right? For this one? Like, everything else... And I'm gonna make the contrast look good. But even for people with, you know, quote-unquote normal color vision, this looks... This is just like, are you seeing... Is this rendered incorrectly? What's going on? The colors are different than I'm used to. And that's the point. Okay, maybe I do need some yellow. No, that just makes it look worse. Huh. Wait a minute. Oh. Yeah, okay. Okay, so Legend of Zelda, like, the deaths still look good because they lean a lot into the difference in saturation between blues and stuff. And they don't completely abandon yellow, they use yellow as a beacon. Maybe I should do the same. Maybe actually yellow as the leaves for this tree. So that's the sunny one. And then let's keep using yellow here for this like mushroomy things. Cause that looks nice. Yeah, that looks cool. Thank you. Oh, that looks nice. Because, like, in the red-green colorblindness spectrum, these trees are, like, a really dark bluish-gray. But the mushrooms, like, are pops of color. Almost looks better in the color blindness spectrums than it does in the color one. It's like, that's just such a neat effect. Blue ground. Oh, yeah. And repeating the mystery of what's up with the colors, because in the Tritanope color spectrum, the ground looks like a bluish-gray. Like, yellowish-gray almost, but in the other things, it's like, pops out so well. So we're doing this, like, balancing of who can see what. And you might be thinking, like, weird for me to put this much thought into how people with different color blindness can see it, but, like, more people have some form of color blindness than you think. I did a survey of, like, the people around my neighborhood, like the grown-ups around my neighborhood, and like a lot more of the table said, yeah, I'm colorblind than I thought, you know? Like, I think it was at least 3 out of 10 people. But you know, that's not insignificant. That's a lot of people. So, And like, I want everyone to see this world and be like, yo, what's up with that? Like, oh, this is alien. But I also want the reader to see everything, you know? Cool. Yeah. This actually looks better in color when you're colorblind than if you're full of color vision.
Thank you.
don't know what I'm doing. I'm just experimenting at this point. I'm just going crazy. No rules, no directions, just start. One thing's for sure, this world definitely feels different from the others we've created for this show. Like, this is just a complete departure from what we've seen so far, color-wise. Going feral. No rules, no laws, just art. Yeah, maybe I should bring a few rules back. Times when I'm glad that I scanned the line art. Because, like, if this fails, I'll have backups, you know? I think I went too feral. I'm gonna try and make it better. Thank you. No, this is actually falling in line with my color guide. So I guess I was keeping a few rules in mind after all, without even realizing it. It's like, it's almost there. It's not quite magical yet. Alright guys, I'm gonna have to leave the stream in a little bit to attend the team meeting for this. So we'll count this as the break that's coming up. Alright, one more color check. It needs some work. This needs love. okay. I'm gonna take a picture of it. Thank you. and send it to my team, and get ready for the meeting. And then I'll be right back after the meeting. So... All right, so I'll see you guys later. Bye.